Hello, I am Sergey, and this video is part of the Debugging Galaxy tutorial. In this video, we will talk about fixing a failing unit test. So, sharing my screen. Here is the tutorial. We are heading to section 2, unit test failure. So most of Galaxy unit tests are designed to test a separate component or function or method within a class. They are supposed to be very fast. They do not require a running Galaxy instance. So they give you instant feedback. Finding the issue causing a unit test to fail usually is really simple. Heading into the hands-on section. Part 1, finding the failing unit test on GitHub. So the first step is to figure out what exactly has gone wrong, what exactly is failing. We need to head over to the Galaxy repository on GitHub, and in the branch drop-down menu, we select the training branch. So here is the Galaxy repository on GitHub. Make sure you are in Galaxy project slash Galaxy. And this is the drop-down menu with the branches. Dev is the default branch. We need to go all the way down, and here we'll find the training branch, and this is what I'm going to select. Make sure you don't forget to make this step, because the bugs have been engineered specially for this tutorial, and they are obviously available only on the training branch, not on the dev branch. Next step, click the red X next to the last commit, you will see a drop-down listing of workflow results and find the unit test slash test parentheses 3 and so on and click details. So red X next to the last commit. The last commit is this one. So 0, 2, E, B and so on and so forth. This is the red X. We click the red X. We get a list of failed commits. We need the one which says unit tests and so on. So on my screen, it displays a unit test slash test 3.6. On your screen, it might be just unit test slash test and then dot, dot, dot. It doesn't matter. What matters is this is the workflow which failed. This is the workflow we need to look at. Click details. I usually prefer to right click and open it in a new tab so that I have the main list of the failed workflows available. I head to the new tab and I didn't scroll down. This is what GitHub does automatically. It scrolls down this long log file, or rather log output, to the bottom, which is exactly where I want to be. And back to the tutorial. I have the solution opened for some reason. This will display a detailed report that includes information about the failed tests. Try to find the failed test. Well, this is going to be straightforward because we see at the very bottom, there are two lines starting with the words failed in friendly uppercase letters. So this is one test that failed. This is the other test that failed. And here is a summary. Two tests failed and 1974 passed, et cetera, et cetera. Let's make sure we have the right solution. Yes, the log lists two failed tests, this one and this one. Now, the first one is the doc test. We need the second one because, well, this part, this section of the tutorial is on unit test failures, and the unit test will give you much more information that you will use to figure out what exactly went wrong. So we need to look at test slash unit slash util slash test utils dot py. And this test strip control characters is the specific test function which has failed. So heading over to part 2, running the tests locally. So an essential requirement for productive development and for being happy as a developer is a fast feedback loop. You want to make a change, run a test, and immediately get feedback from running your test. If you push your edits to the remote fork, if you make a commit and push your commit to the remote fork, whatever you do, if you count on running your tests remotely, you will be sorely disappointed. It will take a very long time, maybe hours, to get feedback. And of course, this is highly inefficient. Instead, you want to run your tests locally. Furthermore, you want to run a specific test that you know is failing, not the whole test suite. So this is what we're going to do in this part. So make sure you are in Galaxy root. I'm heading over to my terminal. This is my terminal, and make sure that that you are in Galaxy root. I'm indeed in Galaxy root, just to double check. Present working directory is, yes, this is the location of my Galaxy root for this tutorial. And make sure your virtual environment is activated. If not, activate it. So my virtual environment is not activated. You will know that your virtual environment is activated if your command prompt has a prefix with the name of that virtual environment. Mine does not, so I need to activate it. The way I do it is by running this command. So again, .env /bin /activate. Don't forget the leading dot, which is the source command. So .env /bin /activate. Now I have the prefix. Now my virtual environment is activated. Moving on. The simplest way to run the failing test locally is using PyTest directly. So the failing test is in /unit/util/test/utils. So PyTest test unit util test util. Holding fingers crossed. Wonderful, it failed, which is good because this is what we expected. Back to the tutorial. Do you see the error message? Do I see the error message? Absolutely. The error message is in bright red color. And here it is. So assertion error, assert BLA equals BLA, but the first one is B space L space A equals BLA with no spaces. And then we have three lines which clarify this error. And again, if you look at the very bottom, you'll get yet another confirmation. Failed. /unit/util/test/utils.py, name of the test, assertion error, assert B space L space A equals BLA. Obviously, one does not equal the other. So this is the specific error. Do you see the error message? Let's check the solution. Oh, yes. So this means that instead of the expected BLA, we got B space L space A with spaces. So far, so good. Three, finding and fixing the issue. Our next step is to open the test file and see what part of the code base, so what module, what class and method or standalone function is failing to provide the expected result. So the failing test is calling. Let's open the failing test first. So the failing test is test unit util. I'm going to open it with my trusted Vim editor. And the failing test was, what was it? Test utils. Wait a minute, we are in test utils. So the failing test itself was test strip control characters. So test strip, and of course it is at the very top, it was looking right at me. So let's take a look at it. We have a string with a special control character, and then we call the strip control characters function, which is located somewhere in the util module. So this line number 21 is the line that's failing. Let's double check the tutorial. The failing test is calling the strip control characters function in the util module. Good. That function apparently is not producing the expected output. Let's head over to the util module where we'll find the function definition. So the util module, and if you look at line number 6, you'll see that this is where the import happens, from Galaxy import util. So we go to lib galaxy util init. The function we need is strip control characters. So let's look for strip control characters. Here it is. It's a very simple function. Let's head back to the tutorial. So the failing test is calling the strip control function. And here is the function definition. So the function takes a string as input, and in theory returns a copy of that string with certain characters stripped away. It doesn't really matter what characters exactly are stripped away. However, from the test, we see that the string is modified in a different way. Spaces have been added between the characters. Can you see what's causing this behavior? So if we take a close look at the function definition, specifically at the last line of the function, we'll see that what it does, it takes a delimiter and uses that delimiter to join a list, or rather in this case, a genexp, a generator expression. So what it will do, it will take whatever sequence is produced by the genexp and join it using this delimiter. And the delimiter is a space, so that's where the space most likely is coming from. Let's double check the tutorial solution. The genexp is evaluated and subsequently joined using a space as a delimiter. Bingo, that's what we thought. The space is obviously a typo. We don't want to add anything to the string, so the delimiter should be the empty string instead. Well, let's fix it. I'm going to delete this space. So now I'm joining on the empty string. I'm going to write and quit. And now I will rerun the PI test. And everything passed as expected. Heading back to the tutorial. Make the change, save the file, run the same test. Now it should pass. Celebrate. Good. Finishing up. Now you are ready to commit your edits and push the branch to your fork. So heading to the terminal, I need to add the modified files. I need to git add. So let's see first, git status. Indeed, I have one modified file. I'm going to add it. And I'll just say git add all. Now my git status has been changed. And now I'm going to commit this change. So git commit. Now pay attention that we need to insert a commit message. Please consult Galaxy Contributor's Guide on details on how to write a useful and properly formatted commit message and why it matters. In our case, we'll do something simple. We'll give it a brief description, an imperative description. So what do we do here? We do not use space as delimiter. Do not use space as a delimiter when stripping away characters. And we are done. And now you would push your branch to your fork. And congratulations. This is the end of this section of the Debugging Galaxy tutorial. You have fixed a failing unit test. Good job.